My name is Sean Chiu, and I'm studying second year filmmaking. I've been in the UK for 1.5 years. Sometimes I find it really difficult to live here. It took me a while to adapt to the culture here, so I wanted to see if any of the other Malaysians are facing the same problem as me. I knew Sarah and Dini back in Malaysia, but we became closer here in the UK.
I was actually really excited, but at the same time I was scared because I didn't know what to expect when I was going to come here. But at the time it didn't hit me yet that I was going to be here for so long. So the first few, when I was leaving at the airport, I didn't feel like that sad. But then after that, I think it was after a week of being here, it just hit me and I was like, oh, I'm gonna be here for so long and I actually am starting to miss everyone back home. Yeah. And this is my best friend back in my hometown. And these are my close friends in KL. They're like family to me too.
Wait, so are they all back in Malaysia?
Yeah, they're all back in Malaysia. They're all Malaysians. Yeah.
But so none of them came here and stuff?
No, I didn't know anyone when I first came here.
So was it hard, like, talking to them and stuff?
Yeah. At first it was hard, but I cannot just be on my own here. So I always have to go out here to be with people so that I don't feel like I'm alone here. So I think that's how I cope, like to keep myself busy.
Keep yourself busy. Mm,
exactly. Do something. Yeah.
There was this one time I was really homesick that I kept looking at the map of Malaysia and the UK, and I was sorry guys, and I was calculating the distance between our place. And I was just calculating the time when it gets to summer so that I can come back. And it was really hard for me.
My name is Mian Ng, and I'm the Associate Head of Department for the Department of Art and Design. But I also work across the Film and Journalism departments as well. My role is primarily to look after international students, making sure that they have an excellent experience while studying with us, and also I also sometimes go and recruit them in their home countries as well, especially the Malaysian students. British culture is very different from Malaysian culture. In Malaysian culture, a lot of emphasis is based on family, friends, and also and less so on the drinking culture as in UK. So when students come over, they find that can be a bit difficult to cope because their network has temporarily discontinued and they are not with their close ones.
Okay, yeah, I cannot wait to go back to Malaysia. Plus, I'll be going back next week. So the reason for me going back is actually because of my brother's wedding, but I'll be shooting some shots of the scenery there. And just to have a comparison between the life in Bristol and the life in Malaysia, like the weather, the buildings, the architecture, and basically how people are in Malaysia. So it's a good experience for people to see what a different country looks like.
Food is a very big part of Malaysian culture. It brings everybody together. My worst experience for me would be missing out on my family events. Like during the whole time of the Christmas break, I missed out on my brother's proposal to his girlfriend. And he was surprising his girlfriend and all my family members were there besides me. So when I was looking at all the pictures, I felt really sad. I should have been there to support him. And I missed out on another very important event, which was my grandfather's passing. I was not able to make it back home because the flight was too expensive. Family is the most important thing in the world for me. It keeps me going. They will always be there for me. So I'm part of the Malaysian Society Committee and we're going to a Diwali event tomorrow, which is co-hosted by the Malaysian Society and the Hindu Society. So we're going to interview some people just to ask them like if they felt the same way, if they felt like the Malaysian Society did help them be able to cope with their homesickness. And the most important thing is like, if will this kind of events help them be able to make new friends, will benefit them in a way?
Hi, I'm Brenda. I'm studying law second year right now.
So how is second year for you then?
Oh, second year, I quite enjoy it. I like it so much because I know how my study and like I know how the culture and all the good things here, especially the weather. I really like the weather.
My name is Ruel Pillay and I'm a Malaysian. Currently reading law in my final year, and I'm the president of the Malaysian Society.
As a third year student, was it hard for you to cope with homesickness during your first year here?
Oh, it was. I was very fortunate because I had to come early because I have family here in the UK. So I came in early about 2 weeks before the start of the semester. And it was easier for me because I have family here. So I was able to spend time traveling, getting to know the people, the university. What helped me integrate was probably when my friends came over as well. I was able to help them meet with the faculty, with the teaching faculty, with the Malaysian Society as well. So it was a bit difficult, but I'm a very outgoing person, so it helped me to integrate by really going out there, really.
Friends back home in Malaysia, is like they know that I'll be going back again, so I wouldn't lose that connection. But the only thing that I was really scared of, like, I would lose connection with my friends in the UK. Because the things, like, we've been through a lot together, like, assignments, the UK life and everything. So in a way, it's really sad. But I'm really happy that I met my group of friends because they became my family in a way. Like my extended family. So, yeah, I'll never forget my friends in the UK, too.
I would say be outgoing. Just if your friends ask you to go out, you just go, because you just have few years here and you want to travel around and you explore UK. That's what I want. Like just this is the best way to conquer sickness, like homesick.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
I'll do it again. I wouldn't stay in Malaysia to study. It wouldn't be different.
We prefer going back home, but we just want to come here to see the world and see how it is. So